It's on.
Okay.
Sorry for the delay. For some reason, Facebook Live wasn't coming on like it usually does. So bear with me while I see if this is set up right. Let's see. Today's flow will be more for like those familiar with yoga, beginner to intermediate levels. And let's see, I don't think no props needed today. So anyway, it looks like I've got that set up right. Let me start the music. Hi, Janine. Okay, we'll go ahead and get started. Coming to our mats. Let's just go ahead and get in child's pose. So taking the knees to the side edges of the mats and the toes are together. And then stretch the arms toward the top of the mat and rest the forehead on the mat. And just coming to our breath. So mentally putting aside your to-do list for the next 45 minutes while we focus on taking care of our bodies, the temple of the Holy Spirit within, and focusing on Easter and Jesus' love and great sacrifice for us this time about 2,000 years ago. So continuing to breathe, inhaling fully and exhaling fully. Let's go ahead and take three breaths together, inhaling through the nose and exhale through the mouth. So inhale through the nose and exhale through the mouth. And inhale through the nose. And exhale, open mouth, exhale. And one more time, inhale through the nose. And exhale, sigh it out. And then continuing to breathe, inhale and exhale through the nose in child's pose. While I read Matthew 28, 1 through 7. Early on Sunday morning, as the new day was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went out to visit the tomb. Suddenly, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven, rolled aside the stone, and sat on it. His face shone like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. The guards shook with fear when they saw him, and they fell into a dead faint. Then the angel spoke to the women, "Don't be afraid. I know you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He isn't here. He is risen from the dead, just as he said would happen. Come, see where his body was lying. And now go quickly and tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead. And he is going ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there. Remember what I have told you." So coming up on the hands and keeping the knees to the sides of the mat, we're going to bring the toes up together in an arch, looking up toward the ceiling. And then exhale back into child's pose, and then inhale, flowing back up into scorpion pose, and exhale, child's. So just flowing back and forth between child's pose and scorpion. And then one more time. Exhale back into child's pose and then up into tabletop. So coming into bird dog, the left arm goes up, right leg goes up, and then exhale, bringing the elbow to the knee. in tiger pose. And then go ahead and release, switching sides, right arm, left leg come up, exhale, elbow to knee, inhale long, exhale, crunch, inhale long, exhale to the side, inhale long, exhale, tiger pose. And then release that. And we're going to tuck the toes under and send the hips high up into down dog, pedaling out the feet. And then maybe take the feet wider and the hands wider and circling around. First one way, then the other. And then bring the feet and the hands closer together. And maybe coming into a twist, grabbing the left ankle with the right hand. And then the opposite. And then looking up with the hands walking on up. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Take the feet out wide, coming into ragdoll, clasping the elbows. Shake the head, yes. Shake the head, no. And release the elbows. Heel toe the feet underneath the hip joints. Bend the knees and rolling on up. Reaching high in the sky. And then clasp the hands together, leaning over to the right. Feeling that nice left side body stretch. Inhale, center, exhale to the left. And inhale, center, bending the elbows into cactus arms. And then clasping the hands behind the back, shine the heart forward. Exhale, fold. Bringing the single fist up to the sky. And then inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, and then bend the knees, rolling on up, reaching up into mountain pose. Exhale, hands, heart center. So we'll go ahead and come into Sun A. And we're going to do the easier, modified Sun A at the beginning because it fits with the Lord's Prayer better. So, first, we're just going to do Sun A, hands, heart center, inhale, reaching up to the sky, exhale, fold, inhale, halfway lift, exhale, hands to the mat, feet back, shift the shoulders forward just slightly, and lower all the way to the mat, inhale, hover the hands, baby cobra, exhale, down dog. Looking up, walking up to the hands, inhale, halfway lift, exhale, fold, and then bend the knees, roll up, reaching up to the sky, exhale, hands, heart center. So since this class is for those familiar with Sun A, we're just going to do the Lord's Prayer without as much cueing. So it'll be more meditative. So hands, heart center, as we say, our Father. Inhale, reaching up, who art in heaven. Exhale, fold, hallowed be thy name. Inhale, thy kingdom come. Exhale, thy will be done. And lower to the earth, as we say, on earth as it is in heaven. Inhale, baby cobra, give us this day our daily bread. Exhale, forgive us of our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Walking forward, lead us not into temptation. Inhale, half lift, exhale, fold, but deliver us from evil. Inhale, reaching up, for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Exhale, hands, heart center. Amen. So we'll one more Sun A, the regular version, with the jump back, so you don't have to jump back if you don't want to. So, let me catch my breath. So inhale, reaching up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, hands on the mat. And jump back into chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Looking forward, popping up. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, hands heart center. Right. Inhale, reach up. And exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway left. Exhale, hands to the mat. Chaturanga. Up dog. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, right heel to the sky. Exhale, right foot forward. Sitting up for warrior one. Exhale, cactus arms. Inhale, clasp behind the back. Exhale, humble warrior. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, warrior two to the back of the mat. Exhale, side angle. And then go ahead and take that bind if you like. Inhale up. And we're going to cartwheel. Come into around the world. Exhale down. Walk the hands over to the right foot. Then inhale up. And then exhale, bending the knees. Toes pointed to the corners of the mat into horse. And you can come in the Texas style version of horse if you like. And then inhale, reaching up into star. Exhale, warrior two to the front of the mat. Setting up for half moon. So launching off, bringing the right hand to the mat. Flex the left foot, helps with balance. And then inhale, reverse, warrior. Exhale, cartwheel down, chaturanga. Coming back to down dog. Catching my breath. Inhale, left heel to the sky, exhale. Left foot forward, inhale, warrior one. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, clasp hands behind the back. Exhale, humble warrior. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, warrior two to the back. And then on your next exhale, side angle. And take a bind if you like. And then pushing up into star pose. And then exhale to the left side, walk it through. Inhale back up. Exhale to the right side, walk it through. Inhale up. Exhale, hands heart center. Knees are bent. Toes to the corners of the mat. And this time, flowing back and forth. Working those thighs. And then inhale, reaching up into star. Exhale, warrior. Two to the front. And then coming into half moon. Flexing that right foot to help with balance. Drawing that right hip back. Pretending like you're in between two panes of glass. And then inhale, reverse. Exhale, chaturanga. And down dog. Let me catch my back. Reach with that left arm, tick-tock, into arms 6 and 12. And then take the bind if you like. If you're working on Bird of Paradise, you can try that. My bird is still trying to take flight. It's not a pretty bird yet. So pushing on up into star pose. This morning, got a frog in my throat. And then cartwheeling over to the left side, walk it through. Inhale up, exhale to the other side, and then inhale up. And then exhale, coming back into horse with Texas arms. Yeehaw! And then inhale, reach up to the sky. Exhale, warrior two to the front. And then launch off into half moon. Right hand comes to the mat. Left foot is up, flexed. And draw that right hip back. If you like, you can wrap that left arm around the back. And I just lost my balance. And then exhale, chaturanga. And then meeting and down dog. Inhale, left heel to the sky. Exhale, bringing the left foot forward. Sitting up, warrior one. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, cactus. Inhale, shine heart. And exhale, humble warrior. Inhale, back up, warrior one. Exhale, warrior two to the back. Reach with that right hand. And exhale, side angle. And if you find the bind, maybe try Bird of Paradise. So, as you can see, I need to work on that. So, coming into star pose, exhale to the left, walk it through, inhale up on the right, exhale down to the right, walk it through, inhale up. So then exhale, hands heart center, toes to the corners of the mat, and flowing back and forth. Inhale, reaching up to the sky, exhale, warrior two to the front, and then setting up for half moon. So the left foot, toes are pointing forward, right foot's flexed. And then exhale, or inhale, sorry, reverse. Exhale, chaturanga. And coming back to down dog. And then go ahead and let's see. We'll come into child's pose. So if you'd like a drink, like I do, now would be a good time to take a drink. So, I don't know about you, but that got my blood pumping. So we're ready to work on crow pose. A lot of people ask, what's the secret of crow pose? And the way I learned crow pose, the secret is where you look. So let's come up, stand up. And then we're going to take the hands to the mat and the feet out just to the sides a little bit. And then bend at the hips, bend at the knees,
want to place the knees like almost in the armpits. And your gaze, instead of most people look down, you know, at their hands, you want to look out here for balance. And then coming up, maybe lifting one foot, maybe the other foot, and then maybe drawing the feet up. And then we'll so play around with that a little bit. So bringing the feet to the edges, and then the elbows on the inside of the knees, hands on the mat, and then you want to place the knees on the back sides, just above the elbows, almost the armpits. And then go ahead and come down. And we'll meet back in down dog. Inhale, right heel up. And then exhale, the right foot on the outside of the right hand. Come in the lizard pose. Tuck the back toe under. Thread the right arm underneath the right leg. Into airplane arms. And then coming back down. Into lizard on the hands or the elbows. Feeling that nice stretch in the inner right thigh. And then coming back to the hands and sweeping that right arm up and back. Maybe finding that back foot. And sweep it back around, tuck that back toe under, send that left hand back up, and then inhale for a twist. Inhale the right arm up for a twist. Exhale, we're going to twist the legs and bring that left hip down to the mat. It's a really nice stretch in the outer hip there. And then inhale back up, and then exhale down, pawing our way to the back of the mat. Heel toe that left foot over to the left side. And then you might have to move that right foot over. Thread the left arm underneath the left leg. Coming into airplane arms. And then bringing the hands back to the mat. And the right knee down. And if you like, lizard on the elbows. You can rest the elbows down. Coming back to the hands, circling that left arm up and around, finding that back foot. And then circle back around, tuck the back toe under. And then inhale the left arm up to the sky. So take that right hand up a little bit as we twist, pointing the left arm to the back and bringing that right hip down to the mat. And then exhale back down. And coming sideways on the mat, you want the edges of the feet parallel with the mat. And then bring the hands behind the back, shine the heart forward, and exhale fold. So if you like to do a press handstand, you can come into a handstand. I can't do a press yet. And then inhale back up, halfway lift. And exhale, we're going to paw our way to the top of the mat. Heel toe that right foot behind the left hand, setting up for pigeon. Draw the toes back to protect the knee. And then sitting up as much as you can in pigeon.
going to kind of do a wave-like motion. And then exhale, sleep your pigeon. Feeling that nice stretch on the outer right hip. We're coming back to our intention.
Jesus, rising from the dead, conquering death
for all of us.
So go ahead and make your way back up to the hands, and then draw that heel in a little closer. And then circle that arm around, maybe finding that back foot, coming into mermaid pose. So sliding that foot in the crook of the elbow, and then taking the right arm up and over and clasping the hands behind the head. And then go ahead and come out of that, coming into a seated straddle. So flexing the toes and then walking the hands forward. And go ahead and come back, walk the hands back. And we're going to bend the left knee. And take the hands, take the right foot up. And the right hand is like on the heel, so we're coming into archer pose. And then the left hand is wrapped around the outside of the right foot. So placing the right hand on the mat, extending up into compass pose. Nice stretch. And then go ahead, bend that knee. We're going to try to get that knee like sitting up on your shoulder. And then hook the feet together and coming up into eight angle pose. So extending the legs out and your arms are in kind of like chaturanga position. And then go ahead, come down. And then we'll do the other side. So bending, so let's go ahead and do a counter pose. So coming up on the left knee, arching the back, and then exhale down. So this time, bending the right knee, and then taking the left foot up. So you've got a reverse grip on the foot, and then placing the left hand on the mat, and extending that left leg up. And you probably have one side, you know, that's more flexible than the other side. This is my off side. So go ahead and try to get that leg up on the shoulder, or as close as you can, hook the feet, and I'll try to do it on my left side. I get stuck, I can't extend my feet out. So just play around with that. So I can get my hind end up, I just can't extend the legs. So let's go ahead and, when you're finished playing around with eight angle pose on the left side, come into pigeon pose on the back. And sleep your pigeon. And then coming back up to the hands. And then doing
the wave, inhaling up, exhale, wave. And then drawing the left heel in a little bit, bending that right knee, and sending that left arm up and over, and clasping the hands in mermaid pose. And then releasing that, and we'll come to our bellies on the forearms, tuck the toes under, and coming into a plank, low plank. Pushing strong out of those shoulders. Strong core. Or at least I'm working on it. We're working on it. Continuing to breathe. And then come to the belly. So grabbing the feet and kicking up into the hands, maybe rocking back and forth, and then release, placing the right ear on the mat. And then inhale as we bring the arms up in airplane and float the legs up. Coming into locust pose. And then exhale, pushing up into tabletop, walking the hands back. And then inhale, reaching up to the sky. Exhale, cactus. And then inhale, shine the heart, clasp the hands behind the back. And then maybe coming into camel pose, keeping the hips above the knees. Slowly coming up, maybe doing a few cat-cows with a counter pose. And then if there's another pose you'd like to do before we settle in for Shavasana, feel free. I'm going to come into a headstand, a forearm headstand. So what I see a lot of people doing on forearm handstands, they have their arms, their elbows spread out too wide. You need to have the elbows, you know, drawn in together. That gives you a more stable support for a headstand. So sending the hips up high, walking the toes up. Then I have to kick one leg up. So let's go ahead and meet on our box. Coming into supine twist. So you want to send the hips over to the right a couple inches, left hand on the knee, draw it over to the left side, extend the right arm out. And then bring your gaze back to the sky and send that right leg out, back over, switch legs. Hugging the left knee up and sending it over to the right side. Such a beautiful day outside. I hope everybody's getting out today if they're in Colorado. It's supposed to be in the 70s and 70s and sunny. And then tomorrow, snow. And the high of what, 32? That's crazy. So go ahead and bring that leg back over
hands come to both knees, circle the knees, massage that lower back, and then reverse direction. And then stretch out. Actually, so if you like, you can either do regular Shavasana, or you can do legs up the wall. So finding a wall that's empty enough, and then setting your right hip up against it, and then swing your legs on up, and you have to kind of walk your hips up to the against the wall, and then feet come up, just like the pose says, legs up the wall. Such a nice relaxing pose. And then the arms are extended out to the sides. Eyes are gently closed. And just relaxing. Letting your muscles melt into the mat. Or in this case, the mat and the wall. And I'll wake you up in a few, 30 to 60 seconds. So if your legs get tired of being straight up, you can also bring the legs out in a straddle position. Or you can bring the soles of the feet together in Paddhamanasana. Take a moment of Thanksgiving. What are you thankful for today? And when you're ready, go ahead and make your way back up. I'm going to set a little closer. So if you'll join me in prayer. Our Father in heaven, thank you for this day and our many blessings. Thank you for coming down to earth and walking among us, showing a better way of life, and giving us hope that there's life after death, giving us reassurance that our loved ones who have already joined you, that we will see them again one day. We thank you for your love that is just incomprehensible. We love you, Lord, and be with each and everyone watching us. Help us to be thankful for what we have. This Easter is going to be a bit different, you know, with churches having to meet online due to the coronavirus. But help us to make this Easter, you know, embrace it, embrace the change. Help us to be thankful for what we have, and we do pray that COVID-19 subsides and be with all those suffering from it, please heal them. Heal our land. Heal our world. Thank you for Jesus and his love. In his holy name we pray. Amen. The light in me honors and adores the light in you. Namaste. So I hope you enjoy this practice. I hope you have a great day. I know for one thing, since it's going to, we're going to have a deep freeze tomorrow, I'm going to be covering my tulips, making little tents over them. So hopefully they won't get frozen. Anyway, have a good day.